Hello and welcome to this new tutorial where we are going to be learning how to connect Google Search Console to Shopify. Now, with Google Search Console, you are able to optimize your content with search analytics. Then I can get my content on Google. I simply submit sitemaps and individual URLs for crawling. And then I can get alerted on issues about my website and I can receive email alerts when Google identifies issues on my website. That is when I'm using Google Console. With Google Console also, I'm able to understand how Google Search sees my page and I can inspect and get detailed information about my pages. So that's the beauty of using Google Search Console. We have a few more down here that you can also use. So to get to Google Search Console, you simply go to search.google.com and I'll be leaving the link in the description of this video and it will bring you to this site. So I'll click on, or you should click on Start Now, and it brings you to this site where you can now inspect performance of your site. You can also get indexing, that is, you can process data, and then you can also view your experience and then your enhancements. When you come to performance here, you can review the performance of your website here. You notice currently we have zero clicks and everything is at zero because we have not added our page here. Then under indexing, you can look at your pages here, but you notice currently our pages are not added. We can also view our sitemaps on Google Search Console and you can submit your maps here. You simply enter your sitemap URL at the top here and then you click on submit. You can also get the page experience down here. You simply click on page experience. And if you have any data for the last 90 days, you are able to get the page experience overview here. And that is, it keeps on changing every month. So that is the Google search experience. And if you look at the links down here, if I click on links, you notice our links here for external and internal pages, we don't have any data yet. So to add my Shopify to my Google Search Console, I simply come at the top here and you notice we have this arrow. I have this site that I added for my Canva, which is not yet verified. And to do that, you simply click on add property and then you can use the domain or you can use the URL prefix. So to do that, you can add the domain here or the URL prefix. In this case, I'll use the URL prefix. And then I put the site here. So now make sure that you have your entire website here. So make sure you have your entire URL here with https://, and then the www, because if you don't have this, you may not have this button activated. So if I actually delete this so that I show you how this goes, you notice now, although I have www.shopify.com, my tab here is not active. So you have to make sure you put from HTTP all the way and then you click on continue. Then it will now be verifying your property for Shopify.com. And then it will bring you to this site to verify ownership for Shopify.com. And then we have two ways. You notice we have the first one, HTML here, where you could download the file, this file. Then you upload to Shopify.com and then to stay verified, you don't remove the file even after the verification method. Other verification methods you can use include using HTML tag, Google Analytics, or you can use Google Tag Manager, or you can simply use the domain name service provider. So those are other methods you can use. At the top here, you can simply upload a HTML file to your website. So once that is done, you click on done. So I'll do that using HTML tag. So I'll come to HTML tag, click on that, and the process is copy the meta tag below and paste it in your site homepage. It should go into there. Then you're told the section before the first body section. So I'll click on copy that, and then I'll come back to my page. I'll come back to my page on my Shopify. Then I'll go to online store. Then down here for themes, I'll click on those three dots and then I'll click on edit code. And then I'll come to my section here. You see the instructions are that it should go in the head section before the first body section. So on my store here, I have this head here, and then down here, I have the body section here. So I'll come there and paste that there. And then I'll click on verify. So the next way to verify this would be using Google Analytics. So you simply click on Google Analytics, and your homepage must contain either analytics.js or gtag.js snippet, and then your tracking code should be in the head section of your page. That means if you come to your store here, and then under themes here, and then you click on this part, yeah, under online store themes, then you click on edit code, the part that we mean, you come here under theme liquid, so you look for this, the head, and then down here you scroll, you find we have the body. And so here we have the body. You notice here is the body. So what this means is that your tracking code should be in the head section of your page. So that is using that method to verify. So you can also use Google Tag Manager. And again, for Google Tag Manager, you must be using the container snippet, and you must have the publish permission for the Tag Manager container. And then once you do that, you will click on verify, and then your account will be verified. So you can also use the domain name provider, which is an associate, a DNS record with Google. So you simply do that now. And so that is how you simply connect your Google Search Console to Shopify. And so with that, I should be able now to have my connect Google. With that, I should have my Google Search Console connected to my Shopify. So, and with that, your account will be linked to your Shopify account will be linked to Google Search Console, will be connected to Google Search Console, and you'll be able now to see all your details here. You notice I can see my analytics. This is just a newly created account, so it may not have sales, but you notice I can see my total sales, sales by channel, online store sessions. I can come down here and look at orders, average order value in terms of the currency that I've set, that is in shillings. And with Shopify, I can see these analytics. You notice currently we just have 000 everything here because our account has just been created and we do not have any data yet. So those are the various methods you can use to connect Google Search Console to your Shopify. I hope this has been helpful. Kindly like this video, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.